breaking he betrayed him. Now Trump's set to fire his ass. President Trump has enough to deal with when dealing with crazed liberals, but you would think that members of his own administration would back him. Well, evidently that was a wrong assumption, as Trump has found out over the past year, as Attorney General Jeff Sessions has refused to do anything about the rampant corruption in the government. During the presidential campaign, Trump promised that he would go after Hillary Clinton for her dirty deeds over the years. However, despite the public support, Sessions has refused to go after major cases involving former President Barack Obama or 2016 Democrat presidential nominee Hillary Clinton. This refusal to crack down on these corrupt individuals has caused frustration on the conservative side as we watch these criminals walk free. Not only has Sessions refused to investigate those crimes, but he has also recently balked over the need to appoint a special counsel to investigate the Justice Department after shocking revelations concerning the FBI had come to light. In a recent statement, Sessions stated that while he's concerned about recent allegations of bias within the FBI, sometimes things that might appear to be bad in the press have more innocent explanations, so fairness and justice should also be provided to our personnel. Then before that ludicrous statement, Sessions again in November pushed back against the need to appoint a special counsel to investigate the disgusting anti-Trump dossier that was paid for by Hillary Clinton and the DNC that was used as the premise for the ridiculous Russian collusion narrative. With all of these instances of Sessions seemingly dropping the ball to investigate these crimes, the calls for the Attorney General to step down are all growing. One of those people is Fox News contributor and former Republican House Oversight Committee Chairman Jason Chaffetz, who has argued that Attorney General Jeff Sessions should step down on a recent appearance on Fox News. Here is more from Newsmax. Former House Oversight Committee Chairman Jason Chaffetz, Saturday, called for Attorney General Jeff Sessions to be removed from office, saying that may be a cure for the deep systemic problems in the Department of Justice. "It pains me to say this a little bit, but I don't think the Attorney General is up to the job he's doing," Chaffetz, now a contributor for Fox News, told the Fox and Friends Saturday program. Sessions had to remove himself from everything involving President Donald Trump, and that led to the appointment of Robert Mueller as special investigator in the investigation into Russian meddling in the 2016 election, said Chaffetz. He also criticized the Attorney General for not taking on a more active role in digging up information about several controversial figures at the DOJ, including Agent Peter Sturzok, who was removed from the investigation after a series of anti-Trump text messages between him and a fellow agent were discovered. Chaffetz said that Sessions also had told him that he would not prosecute Brian Pagliano, Hillary Clinton's former chief tech staffer, who had refused a congressional subpoena to testify about the 2016 Democratic nominee's use of a private email server. Sessions had also refused to make documents on the Fast and Furious scandal public following the death of U.S. Border Patrol agent Brian Terry, Chaffetz said. So, why would Sessions be balking at investigating crimes in our country? The only logical explanation that one can come up with is that he is just another member of the swamp that is protecting his own, and the evidence to support that theory is massive. In an article penned on Zero Hedge, the questions that Sessions could be asking to those involved in the recent FBI scandal are numerous, and here are some examples. Was Peter Sturzok innocently calling Trump a f-ing idiot and a loathsome human before investigating him? Did FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe's damage control team innocently change their conclusion that Hillary Clinton's server was possibly hacked, rather than reasonably likely, language which significantly altered the seriousness of Clinton's mishandling of classified information? Were all references to the FBI working with other members of the intelligence community on Clinton's private server innocently scrubbed from Comey's exoneration statement, making it look like a much smaller investigation? Before he was demoted for doing so, did senior DOJ official Bruce Ohr innocently meet with MI6 spy Christopher Steele, who assembled the salacious Trump-Russia dossier, and then also innocently meet with Glenn Simpson, co-founder of opposition research firm Fusion GPS? Fusion commissioned Steele to create the dossier, which relied on senior Russian officials. Did Fusion GPS innocently hire Bruce Orr's CIA wife, Nelly Orr, to gather damaging information on President Trump? If there weren't such innocent explanations for everything, one might think Nelly Orr could have possibly passed information from the DOJ to Fusion GPS and vice versa. Did Hillary Clinton and the DNC innocently pay Fusion GPS $1,024,408 through law firm Perkins Coie, which then paid Steele $168,000? In addition to the Trump-Russia dossier, did Fusion GPS innocently arrange the Trump Tower setup meeting between Trump Jr. and a Russian attorney? Or attempt to link Donald Trump to billionaire pedophile Jeffrey Epstein? Or try to push the debunked claim that a secret email server existed between Trump Tower and Moscow's Alpha Bank, which Alpha Bank executives are suing Fusion GPS over? Of course, more questions can be asked, but this is a good place to start, wouldn't you say? At any rate, it is evident that Sessions is no longer useful in his position and should step down to allow someone else to do it properly. The American people deserve to see justice. And if Sessions is not going to deliver on that promise, then he needs to step aside for someone who will. It is time to drain the swamp, and it starts with Jeff Sessions.